you believe it has been 50 years, we're talking half a century, since The Sound of Music made its debut in cinemas?
Wow.
It is still hugely popular, with a whole new generation now singing along. Angela Bishop travelled to Salzburg for a special celebration and discovered some surprising revelations about the making of the film.
In this job, I get some tough assignments, but this is one of the toughest. I've come to Salzburg to help celebrate the 50th birthday of The Sound of Music, but not by myself, oh no, with members of the cast of the film. Yeah, you heard me right. In a Studio 10 exclusive, come and see what went on as one of the world's most loved movies turned 50 in the city where it all began.
When the city of Salzburg decided to throw The Sound of Music a 50th birthday party, first they had to put together a great guest list. There was Nicholas Hammond, who played Friedrich in the movie.
I'm Friedrich. I'm 14. I'm impossible.
It is the most wonderful feeling to be back here. I saw the rehearsal this afternoon. Angela, the show is a killer. It is just wonderful. It's the most emotional moment I've had in many a year.
Heather Menzies, who played his little sister, Louisa.
I'm Brigitte. She's Louisa. She's 13 years old, and you're smart.
You're going to get me going now. It's almost a little emotional. You know, it's so beautiful, and I every time I turn a corner, I remember that, and I had forgotten that I remembered that. You know, that tree that was, you know, or that building, or that, you know. So it's kind of like coming back to a hometown after you've been away for a very long time.
I'm Kurt. I'm 11. I'm incorrigible.
Wayne Chase, who played the incorrigible Kurt. I suspect there might be a bit of Edelweiss singing going on. What do you think?
Yeah, I got a feeling. I think probably towards the end, we're going to end up doing it.
You ready?
I'm ready.
And Debbie Turner, who was after a present.
I'm Marta, and I'm going to be 7 on Tuesday. And I'd like a pink parasol.
What's it going to be like to be back in this exact spot where you filmed the farewell concert scene in the movie for tonight's party?
Well, I tell you, I was thinking about it while I was getting ready, and I thought, I just hope I can hold the tears back, because the last time I was here, I was with my mother.
Also part of the celebrations, members of the real Von Trapp family, including Johannes, who is Georg and Maria's son, born after they fled Austria.
It's wonderful that The Sound of Music has played such a huge role in many people's lives and that it's still around after all these years. It's just fabulous.
You look happy to be.
One of the movie's most magical moments recreated when the audience joined in singing Edelweiss.
It was amazing. Well, the whole production was so touching. And it really brought tears to my eyes.
I only wish that our other siblings, Angela, Kim, and Charmian, didn't have other things going on and they could have joined us. I really wish they were here.
It was really quite surreal. Memories were very sharp from when we did it 50 years ago.
This theme of welcoming the real Von Trapps home and embracing the movie, it's very significant, actually.
It is hugely significant. You know, when they were doing the scene on stage as the Von Trapp family is about to flee and leave Austria for the last time, and the captain is singing Edelweiss to his children, I looked out of the corner of my eye at Johannes Von Trapp, tears pouring down his face. And Johannes is a hard man. And I thought to myself, that's his father up there, you know, with his mother, saying goodbye to his own native land, and he's now back and being embraced and being welcomed back to his own country 50 years later. It was a powerful, powerful moment.
These are a few of my favorite things.
Fans approached to share their favorite things about the film, including one Australian couple who had planned their entire honeymoon around attending the Sound of Music gala.
Nice to meet you, Nicholas.
Congratulations. I knew you just got married.
Oh,
we had a wedding in the film, you know.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. We went and saw where that was filmed today.
Oh, good.
Today.
Did you come tonight?
Yes.
Oh, I hope you enjoyed it.
The visit also meant the grown-up versions of the movie kids could revisit some of their favourite scenes from the movie.
You remember the line in the film? The Von Trapp children don't play, they march.
Got
so
it.
We're going to march right now. Five, six, seven, eight. And
a deer, a female deer.
When the movie opened, they became the seven most famous children on the planet, and that means they've remained very close. But just how close were they in the first place? Many of you were in your teens, not so much you, Debbie. Hormones racing. Did anyone have crushes on anyone else?
Oh, yes. I had a big crush on Dan Truitt and this one, too.
Who was the first person?
Dan Truitt, who played Rolf.
Good answer.
I am now occupied with more important matters.
He taught me how to play chess. Yes.
He taught you some moves.
No, he didn't teach me any moves.
So long, farewell.
Well, after such an amazing celebration, there's only one thing to say to the city of Salzburg, and that is so long, farewell, auf Wiedersehen, goodbye.
Mates have lots more spectacular Sound of Music stuff, which will feature in a half an hour special, which will air on 10 next month.
Yay!
Have a good
Yay!